Alrighty, so good afternoon and welcome to the third episode of Getting Spiked with Reagan Distance, brought to you by Tobacco Road Sports. I'm Alex Jangha, and I'll be your host today. Last week, we had the pleasure of having Blake Farmer, a senior here at Reagan, as our host. So my goal is to do equally as good or better, hopefully. So I'm joined here today with five members of Reagan Distance that make up our panel. So each week, we talk to different members, and we sort of talk about what we're doing here at Reagan and so races, highlights, and also whatever comes to mind. So here with us today, we've got senior Brennan Kaplan, if you want to just raise your hand so we know who we're talking to. Sophomore Katie Ryce.
Hi.
Awesome. Sophomore Prakash Keeley.
Hello.
And then junior Henry Johnson. And then junior Kate Henderson.
Hi.
Awesome. So how's everyone feeling today?
Oh, I'm feeling great. Looking forward to it.
Yeah, we're excited. Very excited.
Awesome. Super. Okay, so let's get started with our episode of getting spiked. All right. So last week's panel, we talked a bit about the Greensboro Cross Country Invitational scheduled for Saturday. So that was this past Saturday, and sort of like what everyone was expecting for that race. So Brennan, I'll have you start. So how'd the race go? Tell us a bit about like your plans going into it, how you felt afterwards. But honestly, anything you have to share about that race?
So for me, I was working through some knee tendonitis and some strep that I just had. So a few setbacks. And I was pacing Blake for 16:45. It went well. He had the best race of his season. I didn't feel great because it was my first race back, but I got it done. Helped him have the best race
awesome.
Of the season.
Yeah, that's really good. And I mean, it's good to see that, like, you know, where we're pushing each other, especially like that wasn't necessarily like the hardest effort for you, but just to be there for Blake, that was awesome. How about Prakash? How'd that go for you?
It wasn't what I'd hoped for. I sort of lost touch during the first mile and then never really recovered fully after that, but it was still a good hard effort. So even though I didn't hit the time I wanted to, it was still a good effort.
Yeah, awesome. That's really good. And then Kate, so you moved up to the all-time list for Reagan 5K. So on Saturday, you raced in 18:46, I believe. So that puts you 18th all-time. So how do you feel about your race? Like where you are right now, where you're going, but also how do you feel about being number 8 all-time?
I felt great about my race. I was the only one in the championship race, so it was a little bit weird going into it. Warming up and everything, I was a little bit nervous, but when I got started, I made sure to just get out as fast as I could. I've been working on starting a little bit better. I've done that the past couple of races, so I was able to get out pretty quickly, and I was with about three other girls in the woods, and the whole race I just focused a lot on picking off jerseys, and I ended up coming through it at a PR. I got third place overall. And yeah, I felt really great about it. I'm really excited for where the season is going. I've been pretty consistently taking down some time and just breaking through some mental blocks that I struggled with a lot last season. So my goal is to hopefully be in the low 18s by the end of the season. And I'm really excited for next week, a faster course to try to replicate what I did last week with the help of some downhills and a little bit of a stronger push in the second mile.
No, that's awesome. I can't wait to see what you've got upcoming next week, but also, you know, next year you got a lot of opportunity there to maybe, hey, who knows, maybe you'll be number one by senior year. So that would be really awesome. And then here, Henry, you race on Saturday, right?
Did you race on Saturday? I did race on Saturday.
Awesome. And so how did you feel about that race, and like what would you say was like the toughest part about racing at Hagenstone?
I think the hardest part was definitely the hills, especially the hill at the end towards the finish, and even at the finish, and even the smaller hills like in the woods were difficult.
Yeah. No, for sure. Those were definitely difficult. And then how would you feel like going into Saturday's race? Do you think, like, first of all, how do you feel going into Saturday's race? But also, how do you feel like that race sort of prepared you for that?
I feel pretty good going to Saturday's race. I think Hagenstone prepared me. Like, going back to the hills, I think, especially, I think it's, there's a hill at, after 1 mile, I think I'll be able to attack that better and more efficiently, instead of surging at the very beginning and burning out at the top. So I think I've learned a lot from Hagenstone in how to attack the course.
Perfect. Awesome. That's really great. And then last but not least, Katie. So you didn't race Saturday, right?
I didn't.
All right. And so sort of explain to me what's going on with your training this season so far.
Well, this summer I was doing some training and I ended up breaking my hip. So I haven't really had much of a season. And recently I just started getting back into training. So I started off just doing supplemental work. And in the past 2 weeks, I've been getting back into running. And now I can run every day and I've started getting back into workouts, but I am not going to be racing at all this season.
So no more races. So this the rest of October, you're out for now?
Yeah.
Okay, awesome. And do you think you'll be back for track, or how's that going to look?
Yeah, I think I'll be back. My first race will probably be indoor track season, and I'll probably be ready by then. I was going to race this upcoming weekend, but coach told me that he doesn't want me to, and so I'm going to trust that and just keep working. And so I'll be back and ready for indoor.
Perfect. That's awesome. Definitely don't want to rush back too hard for sure. Want to make sure you're in good shape for that. And so personally for me, like Saturday's race, it's exciting. I'm a little nervous. You know, there's a lot at stake because we don't have that many races left. And I feel like I haven't been able to sort of prove myself yet that I've gotten better. So this will be really a good opportunity to do that. I mean, we've all seen the course before, so we know sort of what to expect. So I think there's always benefit in that familiarity, just knowing what to expect. So that's got mixed feelings about Saturday for sure. And like we got Charlie that's sick today, so that's definitely frustrating. But you know, ideally he's back, but he probably won't be back in full force. But yesterday we had our third CPC meet of the year. Brennan, how did you use this midweek meet at Ivy Redmond to help you? How'd you use that meet yesterday?
So the goal for this week was pretty much just to have as big of a pack come through. Our goal was to cut down from 6:45 to 6:30 to 6:15, put us right around 20 minutes, which is a pace that a lot of the guys in the team can do pretty comfortably. So we were just trying to get a good midweek effort and to just prepare us for Saturday and to maybe pull some people through that aren't racing on Saturday to help them maybe come through with a PR. It was a pretty good effort for me. Legs are definitely a bit tired since I'm getting back into training again, but yeah, it wasn't too hard, wasn't too easy. Yeah, prepared me well.
Awesome. That's great. Especially, I saw a picture of like from mile splits, like 10 Reagan guys coming through the finish together. And that was really awesome. Just being a solid pack. Kate, how did your CPC meet go? And sort of what did you see out of your teammates you were pacing yesterday?
Really similar to Brennan. I was just supposed to be there constantly, keep them at 7:30 pace consistently. We were going to try to come around to 23. We were a little bit off of the time goal that we had, but I think that the meet yesterday went really well. Me, Paige, and Charlotte all worked together to help, specifically Paige Slade. She had a really, really great effort. She was able to just stay focused and keep more of a consistent pace through it, which was the primary goal for her. We had a really big pack of girls through the 1.5 mile as well before they started to change onto an on-off workout instead of continuing with the goal pace. But Slade stuck with us the whole time, and I think we used that race really well to just get her more comfortable with pushing through the 3rd mile. So I'd say it went really well.
Awesome. That's great to see you like helping push our team forward. That's really awesome. And then Prakash, how did that workout yesterday go for you, and how have you been using these Wednesday meets to get better?
Yeah, it went really well. It's just good to know that we're just trying to get our team closer together in terms of results, so that, like, since Charlie's sick, you know, it's next man up, and we can just continue to have good runners to fill those spots. And so we've just been using those Wednesday workouts to achieve that, to just try to stay packed together and get through at a good time.
Perfect. That's great. And then Katie, you were at the race yesterday, even though you weren't racing. Is that right?
No, I didn't go.
You didn't go? All right. No, especially with school and stuff, it's hard to make time, especially when you're not racing. But is there anything like you see in the team that's like sort of changed this season, whether that's times or just like attitudes or whatever? Is there any like sort of growth you've seen from the sidelines in a way that you feel is meaningful?
Yeah, for sure. I've definitely seen on the girls' side, we've all kind of like come together, and I've seen everyone trying really hard at practice and at the workouts, you know, just putting in their effort and trying to get the most out of their training. And I've really loved to see like everyone's times improving and just getting the results that they want to get. And I've also seen like a lot of that on the guys' side, you know, watching their real races and their workouts and all of them coming through at the same time. You know, it's been really good to see them work, you know, as hard as they do and get the results that they want.
Yeah, thanks for sharing that. That's really good. And then Henry here. So how do you feel about your efforts yesterday? And also, how do you feel about your training so far in the season, and where you're at and where you want to go?
The effort was really good. I think we did a good job of staying together, and I think there were nine through the finish line.
Yeah, it was 9-10.
Yeah, so I think it went really well. I felt really good. We had extra. I had 15 minutes after the workout for an additional run, just as a cool down slash. Yeah, just an additional run. And second question, my training it's been pretty consistent so far this season. It's been good.
And do you have any goals that you set for yourself that you have that you'd like to accomplish in what we have left of the season?
I want to improve my PR by, I think, 17:30 is my goal this season, and I'm hoping I can reach that.
Perfect. That's really good, and definitely setting goals is important. That way you have something to work for. And so, yeah, I was with that pack yesterday, group of 10. It was really sort of rewarding to see the whole team sort of working together. You had Brennan here just jogging. You had me. I was breathing pretty hard, but you know, it was a good effort, and I like. It's fun to just see the whole team working together in races. We're all working together, but we're all apart. But at least, you know, for those CPC meets, we can work together and stay together throughout that. So, Reagan distance. We've got an upcoming race this Saturday, Wendy's Cross Country Invitational at McAlpine Creek Park in Charlotte, and so this will be our third time racing this course. This is for many reasons, but Kate, tell us what you tell us about what race you will be in and your race strategy for Saturday.
I'm not sure the name of the race, but it is the first race at I think 8 o'clock, and I am really excited for this race. Like you said, we've raced there a couple of times, so I've been working on learning the course a lot. And the last two times that we ran there, I have fallen off a lot after like 2.5 miles. So I definitely want to get out like I have been, but just work on sticking to someone through the like 2.5 to 3 mile range, and making sure that I don't fall off and I just stick it out, like mentally especially. I'm hoping to go for the podium again this weekend. And I think that there's a girl who runs in the 1820s in my race. So so I'm hoping that I can stay close to her and help push through to another PR.
Perfect. Well, I can't wait to see that on Saturday. I'm really excited for that. And then let's pass the mic to Prakash. So how about you? What race will you be racing in, and sort of how do you feel about it, and what plans do you have during that race?
Yeah, I'll be racing in the open race. It's the first one, I think. And it's good for me because I didn't get to race the last race at McAlpine because I was sick. And Providence, I didn't really have the best race. So I haven't really been able to have a good race at McAlpine this season. Whereas last season, that was my PR for majority of the season. So I'm hoping that I can use my teammates and help push to a new PR and just use them to have a good race.
Yeah. Well, good luck. Good luck with that. I hope you the best, but definitely those setbacks, like being sick and all of those things, can definitely be a struggle. And then how about you, Brennan? So, what race are you racing? How do you feel? What are your goals, for this race? Cause it is a pretty big race after all. So how are you feeling about that? And what are you hoping to accomplish?
Yeah. So I'm in the open race as well. It was a bit of a shock, kind of, to get moved in the open race from the invitational, because that's kind of what I figured we were doing. But, yeah, so the open race, it'll be a lot smaller, most likely, not as much competition. And the goal will really just be to get that team win, I think. And with that smaller competition, I just hope that me and Tate can go 1-2. And just, I don't really know what kind of shape I'm in right now because of my injury and sickness, but it's first race back. I think with the faster course, I definitely have a good chance of breaking 16. But I'm just going out there competing, and time will take care of itself.
Perfect. And now that you mentioned time, do you have any like specific time goals for Saturday, or are you just going to go out there and see what you can do?
I'd like to break 16, but with me so soon getting back from injury, first race back, I'm not really sure how it'll go. I'm confident I can break 16, but I'm mainly just competing and seeing from there.
Awesome. Well, good luck to all of you racing on Saturday. This is a big race, and I hope we all take advantage of it as much as possible. I'm excited for that. All right, so right now, we have most of our Reagan Distance group somewhere on campus at Reagan High School. Some are doing homework. Some are just watching TV. Someone are just playing hacky sack over there. So we're just all doing our own thing, but hopefully all being productive. And so how's everyone doing on the panel so far?
I'm doing well. Liking it.
Good.
Awesome. Awesome. And have y'all seen last week's episode? How do you think this is going a little better than last week?
I think it definitely is going better than last week.
For sure.
Awesome. Perfect. Well, I'm glad to see him doing better than Blake. No need to tell him, but I mean, he'll see this when he watches it. But I see him over there chasing Brody. But yeah, whatever. So every week we will have a new host member on our panel. So make sure to follow Tobacco Road Sports Radio on social media, watch our podcast on their YouTube channel, and listen to us on Spotify. So changing it up each week a bit, this next segment will tell our audience a little more about each of you as student athletes. So Henry, what is your hardest task right now? And why would you say that class is giving you the hardest time?
I would say AP US History, just because it's so many notes that, like, each night I probably have to do 2 hours of notes. And it's just a lot of content, but it's a really interesting class. I really enjoy it.
No, that was a good save at the end, because who knows? You have Miss Cruz, right?
Yep.
She might be watching this, so you got to make sure you're saying some kind things. And then let's pass it on to Katie. How about you? What classes are you working the most in right now?
I'd probably say chemistry. It's one of my favorite classes, but it's pretty difficult. So I've been having to do a lot of studying for that and staying up pretty late to do that homework and stuff.
And then how about you, Brennan? How's your class schedule looking right now?
It's going well. I've pretty easy schedule. My hardest class I'd probably say is either AP Bio or AP Stats. I don't have too much homework for those, but I have a bio test coming up on Monday, so we'll see how that goes. I think it'll be good though.
Oh, yeah, well, good luck with that test. Hope you do very well. And then Kate, how are your classes going, and sort of how do you do that balance between athletics and school? How do you make sure your priorities are in the right place?
My classes are going really well so far. I've definitely got some tough ones. My hardest one right now is probably AP Calculus AB. It's been lots of homework, but I have a study seminar that I've been trying to utilize a ton every other day. And so that's been helping me a lot. As long as I focus a ton, I have an hour and a half to work on a lot of homework. I usually get the majority of it done. And then when I'm at practice, I kind of just try to focus on practice, give it everything I can, and separate them a little bit, get a time away from school, from that stress. And then when I'm home, switch back to school and just make sure to eat dinner and get everything done before, like, going out with friends or anything like that. And definitely sleep this year has been a focus for me. Last year, I think I realized it was something I can improve on. So to stay balanced, I've been working on prioritizing my time, using that study seminar, and getting to bed at a reasonable hour.
No, that sleep one, it'll get a lot of us. It's just hard to manage. We got so many important things going on, and we want to get them all done. So those are good tips, especially that study seminar definitely comes in handy. And then finally, Prakash, how about yourself? How's school going?
It's going pretty well. Calculus is also probably my hardest class, although I have a really good teacher, so it's not as hard as I thought it was going to be, because she's really been helping me understand the concepts, and that's really just, it's been going pretty well.
Awesome. Yeah, same as Kate and Prakash out there. Calc is probably my hardest class right now as well, but it's just, I feel like the consistent homework, and then again managing that with running and sleep and all the things going on, it is challenging. But you know, I've already made it through, like, and we've all made it through, you know, like 2 months of school already. So hopefully the next few shouldn't be too hard. And then next up we have a triple header. So we can go through in order. So starting with Brennan, Henry, Prakash, and then we can finish up with, Katie and Kate. So let's start. Brennan, what's your favorite pre-race meal, your favorite song right now, and your last or favorite book?
My favorite pre-race meal, I always tend to go with some pasta, probably with some kale, some ground beef. It's pretty good. That's what I usually go for. Favorite song is probably Deep Satin by Zach Bryan. It's a pretty good one. Just came out. And my favorite book, I don't do a whole lot of reading myself, but I've read, in English class, I'm reading I don't even know what it's about, AU basketball. It's pretty good. That's my favorite book right now.
Alrighty. Well, thanks for sharing. And then you, Henry. So same question: pre-race meal, song, and last book or article. If you've been reading a lot of articles lately.
My favorite pre-race meal is probably same as Brennan, pasta. I think it really it's like the classic, and it does it. It's good. And my favorite song, any Taylor Swift song. I really like Taylor Swift. And
oh yeah, you make sure to listen to Taylor's version, right?
Yep.
Awesome. Awesome.
Favorite book. I haven't been reading that much. But I think of all time, my favorite book is probably Artemis Fowl.
Awesome. Wasn't there a movie on Netflix about that, right?
I think so. It wasn't as good as the book.
All right. I feel like that's usually the rule. And then Prakash, how about yourself?
I always love to go with spaghetti and meatballs. Team Jenners have kind of ingrained that into my pre-race schedule. Favorite song, anything by Al Green. It's pretty good. And then last book, I think it might have been Artemis Fowl. I've been reading that series.
Oh, fun! Awesome. And then. Yeah, Katie and Kate, how about y'all? Or well, sorry, y'all go ahead. Katie, what's your favorite pre-race meal, song and book?
Well, my favorite pre-race meal would probably also be pasta. Love a good pasta. And my favorite song right now, I think, is Boys of Faith by Zach Bryan. Love that one. And I'm not gonna lie, I don't think I've read a book in like a year. So I couldn't tell you what the last book I read was.
All right. And then Kate, how about yourself?
Gotta hop on the pasta train. I mean, it's a classic for a reason. Definitely try to get that every night before a race. So yeah, any type of pasta really. And then for favorite song, it's probably a tie right now. I really like Everywhere Everything by Noah Kahan, and then just like Henry, big Swifty. I love Death by a Thousand Cuts right now. Yeah, that one hits hard. And then for books, I don't know about a favorite, but right now I'm reading We Are Displaced by Malala. And that one's been really great. Definitely really eye-opening, and I've loved it a lot.
That's awesome. I'll have to check that out. And then for me, I guess, I've been working a lot Friday nights before meet. So I've always been eating like, usually a chicken burrito is the way I go. It might not be the best pre-race meal, but that's just what I've been getting. And then favorite song, I'm not super picky. I usually just get my like playlist and just click shuffle. But I've been listening to a lot of camp lately. That's sort of my go-to, and it's been for a few years now. And then my favorite book over the summer, I read All the Lights We Cannot See. It's like this World War II movie. I mean, not movie, World War II book, and I really, really enjoyed it. So now let's move on from that topic. So last week we talked about races used at workouts within Reagan distance, and we've been doing that for the last few years with Coach Vera. And so, Kate, how do you think this approach of not using like the traditional running workouts has like helped or hurt your results this year and last?
I mean, I think the times speak for themselves. I've been having some really great progress this season. So I think that personally, it's been working really well.
All right. So Kate, how do you feel like this approach that we have of not doing a lot of like traditional workouts has helped you or hurt you this season and our last season?
I think the times speak for themselves. I mean, my season has been going really well and I've been improving a lot. So personally, I think that this workout plan has done very well for me. I've enjoyed it a lot. It's been really fun and I've been able to see really good improvements in my time that I wasn't able to see much last year. I also think that mentally it's been helping me a lot. Vera and I have been working on workouts where I focus on staying with the group or chasing down a group or just really focus on not letting go of the people in front of me, which is something that last year happened to me in many of my races. And I've seen that a lot in my races this year. I've been able to just stay with the pack and continue to move forward, and definitely have been using those workouts to get through some mental walls. So it's been great.
Awesome. I'm super glad to hear that that's been working out for you, because it's definitely not the conventional way of doing things. And then Henry, how about you? So how do you feel about not there being a lot of workouts, and especially like you're a multi-event, multi-sport athlete. So how do you feel like you've benefited from that?
I think it works really well, especially the Wednesday meets. I like not having the pressure of trying to get a PR. It works a lot better for me, and the workouts go much easier. And I'm still getting the right amount of work in. And my times have definitely improved. I've dropped a minute from last year.
No, that's really impressive. A whole minute, that's a lot. And then you pole vault right as well, right?
Right.
Awesome. And do you feel like the doing less workouts have actually helped you with pole vaulting?
Yeah, especially the strengthening workouts where I'm building my core. That's definitely going to help me in pole vault.
No, that's really great. And then, Katie, how do you feel about what's your take on doing less conventional workouts?
I haven't had the opportunity to do any of them yet, but I've definitely been watching and, you know, seeing a lot of people like really improve with it. I think it's an interesting like way to go about it, and I think it you know, shows a lot of good results, and I'm pretty excited for the years to come.
Awesome. Love to hear it. And then Brennan, is it a surprise when coach says that we're going to do a workout, and how has that helped your training?
Can you repeat that question? I'm sorry.
Yeah. So when coach says, oh, we have a workout today, does that come as a surprise to you? And if so, you can elaborate on that. And then how do you feel like those are types of workouts have helped you this far?
Yeah, it definitely is a bit of a surprise thing that we normally use the races as our harder efforts. And I feel like those workouts definitely help bring the team together, since we use like bigger groups and pull more than just the top guys. And it keeps the program strong. Like after I graduate, after Tate graduates, having those training groups is going to help the youth develop more, and it'll keep our program strong for a long time.
That's awesome. Especially, yeah, like considering like trying to keep this program alive past just us graduating, so future generations can use it. And then Prakash, how have you felt? Similar question as everyone else so far, but how do you feel like they've pushed you personally, and how has having less workouts how has that benefited you?
So when I first heard about it, you know, I thought we'd be sacrificing endurance for strength, which I wasn't totally sure about, but then as the season's gone on, we haven't really sacrificed endurance. We've just used the strength as sort of a foundation and then built the endurance on top of that. So we're still getting the endurance in, but it's not feeling, it doesn't feel as hard as it would if we were just doing runs. But with the strength-based training, the runs don't feel like they're a lot of work. And so that's really just helped me improve my time. Like Henry, I've dropped about a minute from last year.
Wow. No, I'm amazed dropping a minute. It's really, really impressive. So this Friday, so tomorrow we have this week's team outing at Paige Askew's home. We'll start with you, Brennan. So what team outings have you been to, and how do you think it helps bring the team together?
Yeah, I've been to a few of the movies. I've been to our dinners at Cece's and at Waldo's Wings. I feel like it really just helps outside of running, bond the team, grows closer, and just build relationships with each other, build friendships that would therefore help the team chemistry and help us perform better on race day.
For sure. And then, Kate, how about you? What team outings, or are team outings good for team morale, and what would you like to do as a team outing in the future?
Yeah, I definitely think that they're great for morale. I think that I think cross country as a sport definitely relies a lot on the team aspects. It helps you desire to like do better and just get out there, and it makes it so much easier to want to PR and want to go on those runs when you have a community around you. So I definitely think we should keep doing these dinners. They've been really great, and I would love to do maybe I've heard talk of the corn maze. Maybe we'll do some fall things, some spooky trails maybe the girls team talked about. I don't know, just whatever we can to get closer, I think is a huge benefit.
Yeah, for sure. A haunted trail would be really fun for sure. Henry, how about you? What are some team outings that you'd like to see in the future?
Well, I think the team outings where we're talking with each other and we're interacting with each other are the best ones. So I think if we hosted like a team game night or just go out to eat at a restaurant would be the best way to bring the team closer together.
I really like that team game night idea. That would be really fun. Katie, have you been to any team outings this season so far? And which one has been your favorite?
I've been to a few of them. I really enjoyed when we all ate dinner at Blake's house and watched a movie. You know, it was very fun and casual, and we just, like, we're all hanging out and having fun. So I really enjoyed that.
Awesome. Yeah, that was a really fun evening. Prakash, what's your take on team dinners? Are you a fan of them? And then what was the last one you went to?
The last team dinner I went to was when we ate at CC's. And I think they're a really good idea because, you know, most people see cross country as an individual sport and that you're running for your time. But it's good to see it as like a team sport. You're not just running for you. You're running for your team. You're going to score points or knock other people from other teams back. And so it's good to build that sense of team community. So you know that you're not just racing for yourself, but you're racing for your team.
No, that was really well said. I feel like it definitely brings the team together. And I mean, I've been working a lot these Friday nights when we've been having these team dinners, but I did go to Blake's house for that one dinner. And that was really fun and just like sort of rewarding to just see the whole team come together outside of those mandatory practices. And so if y'all are reading the reminds, Coach just sent out a schedule with upcoming community service opportunities this October. So what are your thoughts about the opportunity to volunteer to help others in the community, and how does this make you better as a person? So Prakash, I'll have you leading that question.
So I think the community service is a good idea because, you know, we're a part of this community, so we should help to better it. And so doing community service can help us do that.
For sure. And then Brennan, if you want to build off of that.
I think it's really important as athletics to not only push yourself in the sport that you're competing in, but as a person. And I think helping the community is a really good way to bond the team. And I think it'll be really good going forward.
No, I'm definitely excited for that. So lots of great insight about our program as we move to conference competition and the upcoming indoor track. So how do we feel about our chances for success as a team and individually at the conference championship Wednesday, October 18th? So Brennan, you can lead us for that about how you feel about the October 18th race.
Yeah, so We had a lot of success earlier in our city county championship, which was a 2 mile. Me and Tate placed first and second, and our team followed up strong behind us, and we came away with the win. I think it was our first win in like 13 years or something, which is really good to see the program succeeding again. And for this one's a 5K. I think it'll be even better just to get out as a group as we've been working on in these CPC meets. Hopefully keep a tight front pack and come away with another win.
Awesome. Yeah. You won't be racing this race, but what are you excited to see at the Wednesday meet, our final CPC meet?
I'm really excited to see the effort, you know, seeing everyone work really hard to get to this point, and I just want to see the good results and, you know, just the bonding of like racing together and just trying your best and, you know, putting all of your training into the race.
Yeah, for sure. And then finally, Kate, what are your feelings about our last CPC meet?
I'm feeling really good about it. Coach and I were talking about this earlier. Our city-county experience wasn't exactly what we wanted. We didn't place amazing as a team, but we have one of the youngest teams in the county, definitely majority underclassmen, and I think that this season has been great for them. We've seen a lot of freshmen and sophomores develop their times, and I think that's going to continue over the next couple of races. I'm really excited for my teammates and where they're heading. I think we're going to have some sub-20 girls pretty soon, and with all of those younger girls starting to all pack up together, I think that we can surprise a lot of people at conference championships, and I'm very excited to see it. I'm really proud of how hard they've all worked.
No, I'm really excited too to just see how the whole team's gotten better through this season. So yeah, I'm definitely super excited. And then finally, are you looking forward to indoor track season? And how do you think the last few months of training and racing has gone to like help your time so far? And how do you feel going into the cross country season? So Henry, indoor season. So Henry, you can start us off about how you're feeling about entering the indoor season.
I feel really prepared, not just in the track events, but also the pole vault. The cross-country season has definitely strengthened my legs and my core, and I think it'll really help me when I'm trying to get a PR in the pole vault.
No, that's awesome. I can't wait to see. What height are you at right now?
Currently, it's 10.6.
Okay, and what's your goal for this indoor, for that?
I don't really have one in mind right now, but around 12 feet.
Okay. All right. That would be awesome. I can't wait to see that. And then Prakash, how are you feeling entering the, or soon to be entering the indoor season?
I'm feeling really good. Last year I didn't really have much of an indoor season. I went to India for a month and I couldn't really train there. So my times were abysmal when I got back. But yeah, this year I'm feeling really prepared and I think I can have my, best indoor season ever, but yeah.
Awesome. Yeah. I'm looking forward for the whole team to do better. And, Henry, the great, great new heights, Prakash, hopefully, you'll have a better season than last year. But I mean, your times have been getting better. So, I mean, that should happen. And then Kate, how about yourself? What are some goals or what do you have in mind for the indoor season?
I'm super excited for indoor. Like Prakash, I did not have a great season last year. I was not out of the country, but just mentally, like I've mentioned before, just really struggling in those distance races. So this year, with how well cross country's been going, I'm very excited to get out in that 1600 again. My goal is to race that a few more times than I did last year, and to work on getting under 5:10, hopefully. We'll definitely like adjust once we get there, but when I raced at, I'm not sure what race it was, but I raced like a 5:36 first mile, which is faster than I did last year when I was just racing 1 mile. So I felt like that excited me a lot. I think that I'm finally making some progress in those distance races.
That's really great. No, that's for sure really awesome. So I'd like to thank all of y'all for coming out today, making my job really easy as a host, and you know, all your answers have been really, really interesting. So I hope everyone has enjoyed getting to know a little more about our program and continues to tune in to Getting Spiked with Reagan Distance Weekly. So next week's host and panel members will be a surprise, so make sure to watch this week as well as last week's episode on YouTube and listen on Spotify or wherever you hear your podcasts.